is calling.
I wonder, are you tired? Let me tell you something about YouTube. It's going to be important because we're going to talk about that. One of the things about YouTube is this is an opportunity that you can put it on pause. You can get your Bible. You can get a pen. You can get something to make a few notes on. And then we'll just kind of go to school over the next, oh, say, 15 minutes. But let's just, we're going to get started. And that's the opening question is, are you tired? Are you tired? See, I expect many of you have done some backpacking, and I'm here to testify that if you're on a pretty long trek with a pack, that pack can get pretty heavy after a while. It seems like, you know, when you put those straps on, the straps are on your shoulders, and the longer you walk, the more they cut in. It seems like the whatever the pack weighed when you started seems like it's a lot heavier after a while. I swear the army packs that I wore a long, long time ago, I swear some of those packs weighed as much as I did at the time. Not now, but at the time, there were times that they almost matched what I weighed. But see, if you're out hiking, and let's just imagine for a minute that you're walking, and you're walking in a single file. You got people ahead of you, they have packs on as well. And you notice the person in front of you, and you notice that they're struggling under the weight of the pack. You know, they're reaching back and they're adjusting this and that. They're reaching up and they're grabbing the straps and kind of moving around and trying to get everything just right. But they're struggling under the weight of the pack. They reach back, they twist around, they adjust the positions, they do all those things, rearrange the straps to try to make it easier and more comfortable. And then you're behind them, so you reach out at a distance, but you put a hand down and you put a hand down underneath their pack. And you just lift it up a little bit as you walk. You take some weight off of it. You lighten the load for them for just a few minutes. See, it feels like a great burden has been lifted. If you're the person with the pack and you're struggling, it feels like a burden has been lifted when that happens. You know, it just really just gives you some relief. You know, just you kind of go, whew, that feels lighter, that feels better. And see, that's the way it is when you have that heavy pack and you're struggling under that. I think, too, about my daughter Carrie when the twins were little and she lived away from us and she would occasionally travel home on the plane and she would come by herself. So just imagine now you've got two kids, two strollers, and then the stuff you're going to have to stay for a few days. You got your hands full. But the amazing thing, and she'll tell you this story as well, the amazing thing is when she made those trips, just every single time somebody noticed her. And what they would do is they would say, let me carry your bags, let me push one of your children, whatever it was, but they would jump in and help lighten her load. So we're in Matthew 11 today. Matthew 11. I'm going to read a few verses while you're flipping there, and it's short, but I want you to find that spot. It's powerful words spoken by Jesus. So here we are. We're in the 11th chapter of Matthew. We're in verse 28. And this is what it says. It says, come to me, all of you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and I'm humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. See, these verses remind me of that word picture of that heavy pack. Or perhaps it's the person that comes alongside of somebody in the airport that really has their hands full. Because they're struggling under the load they're under. And without help, it sometimes just almost becomes just impossible to move forward with it. See, many of us, probably most of us, frankly, we struggle under the load that we're under. Perhaps the load you have is raising a young family with constant demands. Perhaps it's a wayward child that you just pray and pray that they'll get back and get their footing and get back on the right path and they'll turn their lives around. Perhaps what you feel and that load you feel, perhaps it has to do with illness, or perhaps it has to do with disability. Maybe stress is the load you're under. It could be a job situation. It could be a relationship you have, perhaps with a spouse or a loved one that's just really struggling. Maybe it's your finances. A list goes on. There's a long list of things that, in fact, put us under stress, and that load becomes heavy, that burden becomes heavy. There's no absence of things that put a load on us and put stress on us. Well, see, Jesus, in this Matthew 11, he gave us some coaching. I want to talk to you just a few minutes about some coaching he gives us in Matthew 11. This is where he starts in verse 28. He says, come to me. See, that's where it starts. Come to me. It's not just knowing who Jesus is. A lot of people know who Jesus is. If you ask them who Jesus is, they'll give you a lot of different answers. But, I mean, they kind of recognize the character. But the reality is, knowing Jesus personally, the intimate relationship with Jesus, that's what he's talking to. When he says, come to me, he's saying, I want to have this intimate relationship with you as a believer. And then that goes on in verse 28 and says, it says, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened. See, I suspect most all of us listening, whether it's right now, maybe in the past, but can say that I'm weary. I do feel like I have heavy burdens. I'm burdened up my shoulders. It just seems like it's a heck of a load. And then he goes on after he says that. He talks about the weary and the burdened, and he says a great line. He says, and I will give you rest. I will give you rest, Jesus says. He'll give you rest. We're talking about real rest. We're not talking about the kind of rest where you get a little cat nap and a recliner, but we're talking about real rest as it is in your life. That sounds mighty good, doesn't it? Just having some real rest. It's rest for the body, for sure. But more importantly, it is rest for your soul and my soul. See, Scripture says to love the Lord with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and all of your mind. That's in Matthew 22. It says to love the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. And see, that's the rest that he's talking about. He said, because if you come to me, I'll give you rest. It's a rest that you can have in your heart. It's a rest you can have in your soul and in your mind. And then he goes on in verse 29, he says this, he says, take my yoke upon you. Well, you know, you probably know kind of instinctively about a yoke, but typically it's a wooden deal, two loops on it, and you'd hitch two animals together to pull a plow, a cart, whatever it was, as he was describing it. He says, take my yoke upon you. See, that yoke helps to distribute the load. No matter what they're pulling, it helps to distribute the load. It helped to lighten it when an ox, for instance, came alongside beside the other oxen and they pulled together, because here comes the second one who helps pull. And then he goes on and he says this. He says, and learn from me. You know, I've read this thing. I've read this verse I don't know how many times. But he says, to learn from me. I've skimmed past it. And so it's, isn't the Bible wonderful, because it just wakes you up every once in a while and says, hey, pay attention to this. And it says, and learn from me, he said. See, he's saying, get in this yoke with me, because he just talked about, take my yoke upon you. And he says, get in this yoke with me. Get side by side. And then what did he just tell us? He said, and learn from me. See, it was common for farmers, what they would do is they'd take an oxen who knew the routine, they knew the game, they knew what to do, and they would put a younger trainee oxen in with them. Well, see, the purpose was that the younger one, that's less experienced oxen, would learn what to do and when to do it from the old pro oxen. I don't know if they call them that, but we'll call them the old pro oxen. See, and that's what Jesus is telling us. He said, if you'll come alongside me, there's a lot I can teach you. And see, the amazing thing is sometimes we think about that, and he's not saying, just, I'm going to teach you about heaven. I'm going to teach you about eternal life. Wow. I mean, is that important? You bet. But the reality is he's also saying, I'm going to teach you a lot about life right here on earth. And man, we need to learn some stuff about life here on earth, because we do have struggles. We do have burdens. Not every day is just a flat playing surface. We have a lot of hills. And then he goes on, he says this, back in Matthew 11, he said, "For I am gentle," speaking about himself, "for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." See, Scripture shows us about the gentleness of Jesus. He and his absolute humility. He just talked about it. "I'm gentle, I'm humble." And Scripture shows us time and time again about his gentleness and his humility. And he says, "Come to me." That's the first thing he said, is "come to me." And then he said, "Learn from me." He's telling us, he says, "Don't fear coming to me, because I love you. Don't fear coming to me. I love you. You're my child. I want the best for you." And then he goes on in verse 30 and he says this. He says, "For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." See, life is like a flowing river. And we enter the river and we make a choice when we get in. You got the river, it's got current. And we make a choice when we get in. And we make a choice that we can either swim upstream against the current and fight it, or we can swim with the current. And I'm going to tell you, it is much easier to swim with the current. Well, see, life will bring challenges for us, believe me. Our family has one to contend with right now, if you know us well. You know, we have a challenge that we're facing over the next months. But a life with Jesus, that's really when you're going with the current. You're going with the current. You're not fighting it. It makes the burdens of life, and you're going to have burdens. I mean, we don't get to be Christians and just be burdenless. It doesn't work that way. But when we're going with the current, when we're going with Jesus, those burdens become lighter as a result of it. There's a line in the movie about the Untouchables, and the guy says, he's kind of faced off with this other guy, and he says, "Don't bring a knife to a gunfight. Don't bring a knife to a gunfight." That sounds kind of weird, but the reality here, life here on planet Earth, it's tough. And so just why wouldn't we want to operate under God's big, powerful umbrella? Why wouldn't we want to do that? Rather than trying to navigate life ourselves. It's kind of like the gun and the knife thing. Why go through life and not have all the resources that God can provide you? Why would we do that when it's available? He tells us it's available. These four or five verses tell us that same thing. And this is what I can tell you. His path, God's path for us, is better than our path. And many of us, man, we've spent some time trying to make our own path, make our own decisions, operate under our own wishes, be drawn by our feelings, whatever those things are. But the reality is God's path for us as our Heavenly Father, our loving Father, and Jesus, our Savior and Redeemer, is better than the path that we'll chart for ourselves if you try to do that on your own and without Him. So listen one more time to these short verses in Matthew 11. It says this, it says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened." Do you qualify? And he says, if you do that and you come to him, if you pursue him, if you make yourself available, if you accept him, then he will give you rest. And then he goes on, he says, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me." We talked about that. And learn from me. Because Jesus says, because I'm gentle and I'm humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. And he goes on because he said, you know, it's a yoke, all right. I mean, you know, they put it on what they call these beasts of burden. But he's saying, my yoke, it's easy, and my burden is light. I want you to think about that as you go. Let me mention to you before I close in prayer just a few things. My Miss Karen is, she's getting better each day. It'll be a while before she's mobile, but she's getting better each day. She's got support around her and at home, and so we're thankful for having just that, for that, and the resources to help her get well. Peggy Bubniak today was having testing again. She'd been fighting some things lately, and they just kind of tend to crop up, and she's been doing testing and having some things done today, and Carrie Hill is also going through some MRIs and scans for some diagnostic on her back pains. So I hope between now and Sunday, I hope you'll go back and think about the things we talked about in this midweek service, because I can't imagine anything better for us than asking Jesus and going in and sharing his yoke and let him help us with our burdens and really align our paths in the things we do. God's good all the time. I plan on seeing you Sunday. Let me pray for us and we're out. Father, I just pray if there's anybody listening to this evening, I pray, Father, that they'll examine where they are in life, because Christianity, it's not a game. It's not a sideline. It's not a scrap. But Christianity is, it's our lifeblood. It's who we are. It's what we do. It's what we believe. And as a result of that, Lord, there's great rewards that come from that. There's great reward in eternity, and there's a great reward in the relationships we have with you and have with our brethren down here on planet Earth. And Father, I pray for these people that we've talked about. I pray you lift them up, that you heal them, that they respond quickly, even quicker than doctors can imagine. And just bring them back, Lord. We look for them in our fellowship and in these very uncertain times, whether it's the COVID or whatever the things are that's going on, Lord. Again, I pray that you'll give us peace, you'll give us mercy, and we'll remember that from you comes all power. In Jesus' name, amen.